You were the word at the beginning.
First Paul Christopher.
I'm Emmanuel.
My name is Faith Ibieri Odele.
My name is Taiwo Judah Ajayi.
I'm an audio engineer and I play the keyboard in the church.
I'm a lawyer.
I work with the management consulting firm.
I'm director of people and culture at a company called Andela.
September 2016.
The first service this year, January 8th.
Okay, I was part of the three launch meetings, so when the church started, I was already part of the church.
I started attending City Church, I think it was Easter of last year.
I just thought that I would just come and play the keyboard because that was what I was called to do.
My initial impression was that I found something that I've been looking for all along.
It was a good one. From the first vision sharing meeting we had, I was already excited about the church because it looked like it wasn't just going to be a church focused on itself, its own needs, but it was going to be a church that was looking outward to beyond just the people, members of the church, outward. How can we reach the community for Jesus Christ?
I thought they're just a bunch of very intellectual people who had very intellectual perspectives of the Bible and interpretations of the Bible. Yeah, that was my first impression.
When I joined City Church, I was in a relationship that didn't go well. A lot of things happened that I didn't expect to happen.
So my major challenge was finding a place in Nigeria that believed what I thought the essentials of church life should be.
One of the challenges I had was leadership accountability, church leadership accountability. I had that problem. I was also not sure about community because I think the model of the church for me is the Acts of the Apostles church, where they were family, and for me it was really, it was a big thing.
I think I was somewhat like disillusioned or dissatisfied with a lot of churches and their approach to the human beings and things in general. So, and to be honest, I was also a part of the problem. I was also going to a regular Pentecostal church.
Okay. When I started attending the church as a member, now it wasn't like the other places I've worked. Now, yeah, I was not taken just as a musician, but as also a full member of the church. So I had access to the pastor, and I told him about everything that happened in my relationship. But I was actually thinking, can God forgive me for this thing? Because what I did was big. And I actually said, yes, I can be forgiven if only I can just accept Jesus for my heart and believe that God exists. And he prayed with me.
Okay, so God has helped with that challenge by City Church being the kind of place that believes the things I think the church should have, but also seeing how the gospel connects with all of life, work, marriage, justice, mission, everything, so that a proper understanding of the gospel affects how you live all your life.
Okay, now for community, you know, we have the gospel communities and we are learning the gospel together. So we started with the gospel-centered life this past few months. We just finished the gospel-centered community, and it's really about what a gospel-centered community is supposed to be like. It shows me the practical steps to the Acts of the Apostle Church that I talked about as what I consider the model church, and that's something that I'm excited about City Church. I tell my friends about is that I haven't seen it in any other place before City Church, and it's good. There's also the fact that leadership is accountable, so it's not built around one person. It's not a one-man business, so no, it's a church. There are leaders, but leaders are accountable. And I like that.
It has been just one way, just like a laser focus on the gospel, putting the story of Jesus' redemption, redemptive work front and center of everything that we do. So there's hardly any service or meeting that we have that is not the core, or that is not, you know, highlighted. And that helps to refocus you. And so everything you do draws from that, whether you are, you know, a business person, we are drawing principles from what Jesus has done for us and redeeming us and saving us, and also translating that to your work, or if you're a wife or your mother and all of that. So you have a core that is based on the gospel, and then you can live your life, you know, expressing that in various ways.